Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about how to implement loops using the for statement. This is the syntax of the for loop. The keyword for followed by an item in a sequence. There is a colon at the end of this line. The statement block is indented with four spaces. The for loop allows us to repeat a block of code for a fixed number of times. It iterates over each item in the sequence in order, executing the statement block each time. The for loop is a definite loop. The number of iterations is equal to the length of the sequence, and it is determined before the loop starts. Let's see some examples. In this example, the sequence is a string hello. Letter is the item or index. It will go through every letter in the string hello. This is the body of the for loop. It contains just one print statement. It prints out one letter in a separate line for each iteration. The result is hello printed vertically. The total number of iteration is 5 because there are 5 letters. In this second example, the sequence is this list, colors, which contains 3 different color strings. This color, singular, will go through every item in colors, plural. Each iteration of the for loop will print out one color. This is the output. The total number of iterations is 3 because the list contains 3 elements. In the third example, we import the math library because we'll use the sine function. In this example, the sequence is a range from 0 to 3. It contains integer numbers from 0 to 3, including 0 but not including 3. The loop index x will go through every number in this range. For each x, the following 3 statements will be executed. Print x value, print sine x value, and print an empty line as a separator between different iterations. Here is the output. The total number of iterations is 3, because this range contains 3 integer numbers. Next example. This is a list of lists. The length is 3 because it contains 3 elements. The length of the first sublist is 1, because we have just 1 float number. The length of the second sublist is 2, because we have 2 strings. The list of the third sublist is 3 because we have 3 integer numbers. We want to print every element in all the sublists. We need a nested loop. That means one loop inside another. The top level for loop will use the loop index sublist to go through every element in the list of lists. We further use the loop index x to go through every element in the sublist and print out the element. This is the output. The total number of iterations for these 2 levels of for loops combined is 6. The following main function asks the user to input key numbers and then outputs average of these numbers. After the number k is entered by the user, we initialize the total to be 0. Next, we loop k times, each time asking the user to enter a number, adding this number to the total. After the loop is done, we calculate the average, which is the total divided by k. Finally, we do the printing to show the values of k, the total, and the average. Call this main function. Enter the value of k. I'll calculate the average of 3 numbers. Enter the first number, 4. Enter the second number, 5. Enter the third number, 6. Here is the output. You entered 3 numbers, the total is 15, the average is 5. Interactive loops are tedious and error-prone. This is especially true when we are dealing with large datasets. What if we made a typo on number 79 out of 100? We have to start all over again. A better way is to read the data from a file. The following program calculates the average of all the 30 numbers in the data1.txt file. When we open this file in Notepad, you will see that each line contains at most one number. Some lines are empty. Now let's do this in this new main function. We initialize k, which is how many numbers we want to use to calculate the average. The total is the sum of these numbers. I have already talked about how to read and write files in a previous video named Text Files in this course. Open this file using the with statement in the reading mode. Give it a name, f. We use the readLines method to read all the content in the file and give it to a variable named data. We print data to check its content. This is a large list. The first element is the first line. It is just one number, 85. Backslash n is the line break. The second line is 82 backslash n. The third one is an empty line, and so on. Let's compare it with what we see in the notepad. It seems about right. For each element in the data list, we check if it is just an empty line. If it is not an empty line, we increase k by 1 and add the number in this line to the total. After each line is processed, we calculate the average and print out the results. 30 numbers were read from the file. The total is 1,500. The average is 50. Here is another version of this program. It still calculates the average of all the 30 numbers, but this time the data are in the data2.txt file. Each line may contain one or more numbers, separated by a comma and a space. Some lines are empty. Let's update the program. There are a few differences between this program and the previous one. The file's name in the open function is changed to data2.txt. When we show the data, we see that we have 85, comma, space, 82, then backslash n, which is a line break. The next two lines are blank, and so on. We need to use a nested loop this time. The top level for loop will go through all the lines in the file, and the second level for loop will process all the numbers in each line if that line is not empty. Run this program. The result is exactly the same as the previous program. Okay, that was all about the for loop. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.